basketball on M-Link. We're inside the David Brady Athletic and Recreation Center. Currently, the Mohawk Mountaineers are finishing up a bit of a pregame ceremony in which they are celebrating the careers of Sergio Bolzon, a member of the men's basketball team from 1984 through 1986, and Manny Campbell from 2011 to 2013, two of the OCAA Hall of Famers and Mohawk Mountaineer Hall of Fame members, celebrated here this afternoon prior to tip-off of the season opener of the 2016-2017 season for the Mohawk Mountaineers and their home opener versus the Niagara College Knights. Nick Burney alongside me, Sadie Martin. As always, with us is Christine Midgley on the sidelines. And as we get set to begin today's game, the starting lineups are just being announced for Niagara College. And one thing to take a look at for the Mountaineers on the men's side is the fact that last year, this was a veteran-laden team. They made their run, and Brian Jonker was ever so slightly maybe disappointed they didn't reach the pinnacle and take over on the CCA level. Unfortunately, they've had a lot of ins and outs, a lot of players who have left due to their graduation and moving on in their careers, as well as a lot of new faces now that have come to the team.
Yeah, like we lost Matt Fennell last year, who was an all-Canadian amazing basketball player. But now we have this Matt Elgok player coming to. This is his first season playing with us. And the last three preseason games, he scored 25 points, 25 points, and 31 points was his last game. So I think definitely he's someone who's going to show us a good game tonight.
And you can include in that Nathan Berry, Jared Camru Peacock, who they've asked us to just call Jared Peacock, as well as Ahmed Gaffer and Mohammed Gaffer, the two twin brothers, Jalen Bailey, as well as Ty Urig, Mohammed Hassan, Jordan Martin, and of course, as mentioned, Matt Elcock, all are rookies. All
we have
are
a lot of rookies.
And there is over six first-year players on this roster. And as we go into the starting lineup, Matt Elcock will be one of the starters the first year. Kareem Collins, Jared Peacock, with Lamar Barr and Jesse Broad, two of the returning veterans. And on the other side, for the Niagara College Knights, we will see Laquan Hilton, Jordan Wilson, Van Hutchinson Jr., Vikram Kaley, and Levi Makuna, who are wearing 7, 8, 11, 13, and 14, respectively. The season opener and home opener for the 2016-17 season for the Mohawk Mountaineers men's basketball team, and we are underway with the tip. And coming up the court, Matt Elcock, who will find Kareem Collins to begin. Collins looking down low for Peacock, but it went through his arms. And now Niagara off the turnover coming forward. Bringing up the ball, Laquan Hilton at the top of the key. Finding at the top, Van Hutchinson Jr. Now across, Makuna puts up the up fake. Down low in the post, it's Wilson. Down low, he finds Kaley off the cut and unable to finish.
Oh, now Niagara fighting for that ball.
And on that battle for the loose ball, as you mentioned, Van Hutchinson Jr. able to win possession, and it will be Door. Niagara's ball on the baseline.
Door.
So Laquan Hilton to inbounds. Van Hutchinson Jr. the up fake. Now up to the top, Wilson swinging it around. Makuna. With the shot clock winding down, we see a long range triple drilled by Laquan Hilton, and Niagara lead 3-0. So the first points of the season for Niagara College, against Mohawk College from Niagara. Niagara has already a game under their belt, and the Mohawk men team, this their season opener. Jesse Broad, the Australian, outside. Kareem Collins drills the three, and a good response.
Yeah, good start for both teams. It looks like it's going to be a three-point shooting kind of game.
Expect a lot more from Kareem Collins, and this his second year on the team. Down low, Peacock battling. Ball to the corner, quick upshot off the top of the backboard. A big miss from Van Hutchinson Jr.
And I think we're going to see, especially tonight, Lamar Barr and Kareem Collins are going to have to be really like the leaders, especially with the starting lineup. We have a lot of
Elcock
young players.
Trying to set a screen there, run over by Makuna. Ends up getting up and, hey, almost able to make that three a little off to the right. And there's a good defensive play by Kareem Collins getting back on the other end, cutting down a pass before it gets to its intended target, Makuna. Early in this one, back and forth, just a three-pointer made for either side. Hutchinson Jr. to the corner. Hilton thought about going up again with another three. spinning. Tries to go down low with the pass to Wilson, picked off by Collins. Here comes Kareem. Up the court himself, goes outside. Elcock for three, blocked away. The loose ball picked up by Barr, but only for a second. He could not gain control. And it's Niagara ball from the touchline.
And a little bit different style game than what we watched of the women's. It looks like they're both playing a zone defense. We're not seeing the fast pressure. Both teams look like they're kind of feeling each other out and seeing what's going to work against each other.
Mohawk choosing to play man-to-man for the most part.
Good job, Bubba.
And there's an open three missed from the corner by Kaylee. Back the other way, Collins. Again with pressure, driving the hoop, does not get the call and cannot put it home. And on the loose ball, it'll fall out of bounds and be Mohawk possession. Good chase by Lamar Barr, or excuse me, they're gonna now call it Niagara College ball. And Lamar Barr cannot believe it. Back the other way, Laquan Hilton, quickly up with pace. Looks for Wilson, uses him as a decoy, finds Makuta in the corner. Now all the way to Kaylee, inside. Big move to the rim by Wilson, and he finished. Jordan Wilson with the good right-handed finish puts Niagara back out in front 5-3. Kareem Collins at the top. Jesse Broad at the top of the key. Jesse Broad finding Elcock. Long range triple drills it, and Matt Elcock with his first points of the new season as a Mohawk Mountaineer in his first year.
Corner!
Makuna to Hilton inside. Quick turn by Wilson. Good up fake. Goes up on the right hand and puts it in off glass.
Seeing Niagara's using a lot of inside game against the Mohawk defense right now.
A little inside outside work with Hilton, who's threatening because of that earlier
nice
three.
Steal.
And there's a good steal off of Collins, and it ripped out of his hands, and Hutchinson flies to the rack with ease. So Niagara, with a couple quick scores, have taken a 9-6 lead here in the early going. And Lamar Barr now. Barr at the top of the key. Elcock open three again off the curl, but he just missed. Clearly that's Elcock's shot.
Yep.
He loves coming off that pick and roll.
Let's go hit it. Run.
Hutchinson tried to a handoff and got it taken away by Elcock. Now Kareem Collins slowing it down. Elcock off the pass, finds Broad open for three. Jesse Broad, ball just a little hard off the rim. Wilson with the board.
We're having a lot of quick turnarounds. It looks like Mohawk's on their feet for their defense and they're getting down the floor.
Van Hutchinson Jr. with the handoff. Makuna finds Hilton and he drills another three from the corner. 12-6 Niagara, and Coach Brian Jonker is going to try and put an end to this little run.
Yeah, already that was Hilton's second three and we're only not even halfway through the first quarter. So it's definitely something you want to be putting a stop to.
And Laquan Hilton, based off the fact he's got the two threes and two shots, you've seen him come down the court and use that to his advantage, allowing Mohawk to come forward on him, and as you said, then they will shift the ball down low inside, and as they get closer and more inside, they're working it around, and they're getting those easy buckets right now. And we'll take a couple looks here at the first few scores from our game as we get a couple highlights thrown up on screen. Here's Niagara College working that ball around in that early triple from Laquan Hilton. And then you
great
can see Jordan
move.
Wilson, like you said, with the inside right hand. And again, Laquan Hilton showing off his range from beyond the arc, and that's given Niagara College a bit of an advantage here and an early quick start that Mohawk,
and to
I don't
be making
expected.
Your threes early in the game, that's a good spot. It boosts your confidence, and you know, I'm sure they're going to be taking more of those shots. Mohawk, on the other hand, I don't think they've quite found their groove. I think watching them so far, it looks like there's a lot of people kind of working individually. There's not a lot of team play happening so far.
And one thing, Matt Elcock, he's getting open off the screen. He's looking available. And like you said, he was leading the team in scoring in the preseason, something surprising.
Yeah, like I'm looking to him like explode.
And it looks like he's on the verge of. He hasn't been able to get the shot to fall a few times. He's only made one shot, one of three from beyond the arc. Lamar Barr inside, finds Peacock. Peacock battles down low to make position. The loose ball rebound couldn't get jammed home by Broad.
That's it.
Comes back to Collins.
That's
now to Elcock. Real long three, and he drills. And you can see he's comfortable with that
shot.
Yeah,
100%.
So that cuts the deficit to three. Makuna outside Hilton. Hilton spotting up. He's feeling good. Oh. Good fake across to Hutchinson Jr. A little step back. Hutchinson coming towards the rim. Now finds Makuna outside in the corner, and he cannot hit the three. Barr had it knocked out of his hands for a second, but then regains it, leading for Jesse Broad, who tried to go behind the back and keep it in and could not. But as we take another look at that deep range three from Matt Elcock, who was well outside the three-point line and even the NBA three-point line for that one. As you get this other view possibly coming on the way here for the inbound. Great shot from Elcock. Great work.
And no hesitation there, and he's like 2 feet away from the three-point line.
Clearly a confident three-point shooter. A big reason of why he was leading Mohawk in scoring through the preseason.
Yeah,
there's Elcock with a good little pro hop move inside. His pass quickly played from Gafer down to Urig. A pair of newcomers and lost off the hands and out of bounds. And you can see a little bit of a little bit of anxiety from the newcomers.
Of course.
Not quite being as aggressive as the other veterans. Thus far, Elcock, quick set up three. No good, off rim and out. He has not missed one by a major amount. He's been close on every shot. Just hasn't gotten them all to fall. Van Hutchinson up the way. Back from Wilson, now to Van Hutchinson again.
And Van Hutchinson, he had a great season opener for him. He had 18 points and 10 rebounds.
And
so first game of the season and got a double-double. So I'm sure he's going to be a huge key player in this one as well.
Trying to continue his success in the early going. Makuna puts that easy two home. And then Collins drives with his head down, a foolish drive into the three-man defense. And it's taken away by Niagara.
There's nowhere for him to go there.
And Hutchinson sets up long range, triple off front rim, a little low and short on the shot, and it will get out of bounds just off the fingertips of Payam Saboni, the fifth-year player from London, Ontario. Collins inbounds to Elcock. Mohawk trail 14-9 with 4:17 to play first quarter here. Collins, not a lot of movement right now from anyone on the Mohawk offense.
Yeah, the shot
Collins
clock
again,
already down to
back.
10.
Down low, battles, hung too long, too much on it. Same with Greer off the rebound, trying to go up too quick.
And we're not seeing like a lot of movement on Mohawk's end. You know, Kareem Collins, he had to take it to the net himself. No one's really moving around and getting open and giving him many opportunities.
And a very bad mistake on a giveaway down low from Adrian Achonwa allows for an easy bucket for Levi Makuna. And Niagara College now all of a sudden are up 16-9. Collins down low, Elcock, good little move to get down low, but he swatted away on his shot. And that will go out of bounds, luckily off Payam Saboni for Mohawk's case, who keep possession.
I think Niagara is using a lot of Mohawk's mistakes to their advantage. You know, when Mohawk does give away the ball or fumble it a little bit, Niagara's right there putting those 2 points in the bucket. So
Urig outside to Greer. Down low, quickly swung around by Jordan Martin to Alcock, and now to Urig. Now back inside to Greer. Great finish, but did he get it off? And they are going to call it and one because of the foul came just before the shot clock hit zero. So it is a basket. Count it and the foul, I believe. So 16-11 now for Niagara. And the first shots from Muhammad Gaffer. And we'll take another look as he makes the and one to complete it and cut the deficit to four. Take a look at that replay there. Great little feed and great finish as the shot clock expiring. Back the other way, a quick jump shot off front rim and out, popped up in the air, grabbed by Van Hutchinson after Saboni miss. Down low, Makuna. Van Hutchinson out for three on the quick trigger pull, drains it. Niagara lead by seven. Jordan
and Niagara,
Martin.
They're getting those second opportunities. They're dominating their offensive boards.
Gaffer to Martin. Jordan Martin down low. Urig, look for the handoff. Looked again. Now finds Martin open. Two shot from the corner. No good. Rebound off the fingers of Anchanwa and coming forward. Hilton down low. Van Hutchinson with a great left-handed finish, and Niagara running the court with ease against Mohawk 21-12. Here's Alcock now. Driving in, finding Achonwa, but he was taken away. He wasn't ready for the pass. Van Hutchinson up the court. Now subbed on. Alex Elliott cutting to the rim, and he's called on a carry. And that turnover will give Mohawk possession back as they trail by nine in the early going here. 2:22 to go, first quarter.
Sorry, but I'm just letting you know.
Muhammad Gaffer will inbound from the sideline in front of the stands. Quick little give and go. Gaffer waiting. Back to the top. Jordan Martin, quick pass. Here's Peacock. Jared Peacock to Ty Urig. Across court pass to Martin. Driving towards the hoop. Martin kicks it out. Mom and Gaffer from the corner drills it.
Nice shot.
And he's cut the deficit.
There was a lot better movement there on Mohawk's end of things. They used the clock a little bit more and had some better passes.
Quickly, Elliott thought about shooting the up fake. Now Payam Salami with the shot. And Susie Saboni able to make the three for Niagara the other way. And it's
looks
a
like
nine-point
there's a lot of
again.
Niagara shooters that can shoot that three. If you leave
they
them open, they're making them.
Martin swatted away by Makuna. Down low. Elliott gets it the other way. Quickly up court on the counterattack. Elliott's rebounding shot eventually falls to Gaffer, but
oh,
he turns it over to Hutchinson, who spins and can't hit the lay-in. A very athletic play to try and make that. And oh no, a turnover by Mohawk for not being focused. And the three is drilled
and those
by Laquan Hilton.
And Niagara makes some
and it's
regret
27-15. Martin to Peacock. Quick three the other way off back iron. He forced it. Uri got his hand on it but couldn't win the ball. And that will go out of bounds right in front of us. And it will be Niagara College ball. I believe, no, excuse
Mohawk.
Me, they're going to give it to Mohawk. So Mohawk able to keep possession. It'll be Peacock in front of us as Kareem Collins will enter back into the game. And we will see Adrian Achonwa make his way to the bench.
Is it 14 seconds or 24?
So the shot clock reset, as you can see, Keith Vassell just making sure. There's a quick little handoff play at the top of the key, down low gets to Urig. Urig inside, dribbled it off his own knee though and lost possession. And suddenly Niagara can work out. It's Romello Taylor. Taylor working up court with speed, little handoff Makuna around to the top of the key, feeling good, drives and launches a three off the front of the rim. But the quick escape pass from Mohawk off the hands of Gaffer and out of bounds. Sloppy play has dominated the first quarter for the Mohawk Mountaineers. 35.4 seconds is all that remains in this first quarter. And a quick spot up shot by Taylor misses off back rim, but Urig lost control of the ball. And more sloppy
we're
play.
We're seeing lots of sloppy play from Mohawk.
Has affected Mohawk.
And especially in Niagara's end, the place that you don't want to be having sloppy play. Niagara's getting those offensive rebounds and putting it right back in their face.
And they have handled it very well in this first quarter in Niagara College. And there's a big block from Urig. But unfortunately, a foul called on him as he went up. A little too much body on the play. And it will be two shots for Payam Saboni from the line. Niagara dominating this first quarter with just 22 seconds to play. In front by 12 as we stand, and now 13 as Saboni makes the first of two. Shot is missed off the rim. The rebound finally grabbed by Mama Gaffer and then almost thrown away, but Jordan Martin able to succumb the play and slow it down a bit over the timeline for Mohawk. Jordan Martin working on Taylor. Outside, Gaffer for three. Got it.
Good play.
Gaffer drills and he brings it within 10 points. Mohawk needed
that. Was great execution of a play too.
Time running off the clock. Elliott has to hurry. He gets it off and it's well short. And that'll bring an end to the first quarter of play. Niagara in front 28-18 over the Mohawk Mountaineers. Their season opener has not gone according to plan thus far. And as we take it to the end of the first quarter, we'll show you these highlights we have. And most of them, the Niagara College three-point shot that has been falling all day. And it's been led by Laquan Hilton.
Yeah,
but
they're
everyone
confident.
Seems to be getting into the party there.
Yeah.
And as we...
And leaving them wide open, too. And when that happens, they don't need those second and third opportunities. They're making them that time.
And as you see, with the success of Niagara from the three-point line, will that open up Mohawk for more inside plays, considering Niagara started by going inside to draw to that outside play? While we're on our first quarter break, we're going to turn it now over to Christine Midgley, who's sitting on the sideline and has a little bit of an info update on the coaches from what their perspective is going forward in this opening game.
Thanks, Nick. I had a chance to talk to Coach Jonker at the beginning to see what to look for in today's game, and his answer was new faces. The Mountaineers actually have 8 players who have joined the team this year straight out of high school, which is a crazy turnover. Mohawk has experienced this kind of change in a long time, so Jonker really does have a lot of teaching ahead of him. Now, according to the coach, the team is still a work in progress, but it's going to be really exciting to see where they end up come January. In terms of today, in order to pull off a win, Mohawk really needs to focus on boxing out Niagara. Niagara's a strong, active team, and they excel on rebounds, as we've seen in this first quarter. So defense, having a really strong defense and ball control is critical if Mohawk wants to pull off a victory in this game.
Thank you, Christine. And I will say, 8 new faces is not an
right
easy
from high school too.
Thing to incorporate into a new team, especially, as you say, as young as they are. And we've seen some impressive play. Matt Elcock has looked far beyond his years. But like you've said, we've seen a little bit of nerves from Ty Urig, as well as Jared Peacock in their first moments, as well as Muhammad Gaffer when he's been on the court. So learning experiences right in front of our faces for Mohawk College in this season opener. It begins right here today. And there's Ty Urig grabbing the board as we begin this second quarter with Mohawk trailing by 10, 28-18 against Niagara College. Kareem Collins from the top. He is the ball handling leader, and he gets it down low to Urig, who went for the slam and is blocked, but draws the foul, and that's exactly what he needed to do, was go up strong and try and get that thing down with some authority.
And we've been talking about rebounds and how Niagara's dominating that side, and it sounds like Jonker was aware that that was what was going to happen today, and I think we can agree that Mohawk needs to be boxing out and getting those rebounds, because when you give Niagara second and third opportunities, they're making them.
And Urig, unable to hit the first attempt, missing from the free throw line. Misses both. The rebound, though, tipped back out, and Collins can pick it up. So still possession for Mohawk. Bar open outside, wanted it. Too hard on the three. Unfortunately, had to wait too long for the ball to get to him. Alex Elliott the other way, driving. Finds his man Makuna outside, but a call made as he was on the touchline, out of bounds, with his back foot. Bar to inbound from the sideline. Collins. Up court again. Has been the ball handler and leader right now on the
Niagara's
offensive end,
but there's
a terrific play by Saboni to block that in-turn pass by Jared Peacock. And back the other way they go. Elliott just throwing it up. Good swap by Gaffer, but he'll draw the foul. And it's on the chop there from Urig. So Jesse Broad will sub on, as well as Matt Elcock coming back on. Ty Urig and Muhammad Gaffer will sub back off and get a rest. Early second quarter. Elliott hits the first of two. Mohawk had looked pretty good coming into this game, even though they had lost in the preseason to Nazareth College. They had then defeated Loyalist and Seneca before defeating George Brown, all the way led by Matt Elcock with 25, 25, and 31 in their most recent game against George Brown College.
And Matt Elcock is sitting at 6 points right now, but I was still expecting more seeing those numbers. I hadn't actually gotten to a preseason game, so I was wondering what his game was going to be, whether it was inside or outside. But I think when he starts making his three-pointers, that's where the bulk of his points come from.
And a big block there as Kareem Collins went up strong. Mohawk will take it from the baseline with just 10 on the shot clock and a good inbounds, but a block again as Makuna got his hand in on the Peacock shot, but a travel will bring it back as Jordan Wilson didn't get his dribble down in time to catch up with his feet.
Niagara's defense is tough. They're not really letting anything inside.
Niagara has been tough in the paint against Mohawk in the early going of this one. Ball down low. Matt Elcock outside. Goes back to the top now. Bar. Bar will drive to the paint. Now pulls up and tries to hit and misses about the 8-foot jump shot. Back the other way. Here's Romel Taylor, and he's hit with a chin check. And Romello Taylor drawing the foul. And that will be on 23, Jordan Peacock. So ball to be inbounded by Makuna from the sideline. Jared Peacock, not Jordan. Romello Taylor.
Good defense by Kareem.
Battling hard with Collins. Now going with a running right hand that drops. And it seems like everything's working for Niagara and nothing for Mohawk in the early going. Elcock on the handoff. Now to Broad. Looking. finding Barr. Trying to get some movement in this offense and get something going here. Lamar Barr spinning back, turns the other way. Now
Niagara's packing in the key. They're not letting anything
in. And a great little passing play between Jared Peacock and, of course,
it was good. They made the Niagara inside defense shift a little bit because they're playing them really high up on the two elbows. So if they can get some lower movement going on, I think they'll get more opportunities that way.
Ball down low, blocked away by Jared. As Peacock gets his left hand in there, he's been more aggressive and more into the game as we've gone along here and gotten into our second quarter. And we'll just take a quick look here at that great pass that he just made, finding Jesse Broad, the Australian international, underneath the hoop for a great little one-touch finish. Great little pass from Peacock
passing before
he got back.
I don't even think his feet were back on the ground when he passed that.
So Alex Elliott now from the top. Looked back for a pass to Wilson. Instead takes a really ridiculous shot. And it comes out. And the rebound off of Wilson. He felt like he was fouled by Collins or Peacock. And instead a non-call. The ball will be marked as out of bounds and Mohawk ball. So Elcock, Collins, along with Broad and Barr. And now Peacock will get a rest. And Mohammed Gaffer will come back on for Niagara.
And Mohawk, I think they're holding their own a little bit more. Their defense is picked up. Niagara's not getting as many easy looks as they did early on.
Makuna still on the court, as well as Vaughn Hutchinson Jr. return. And also Vikram there's a miss. And now Taylor the other way, Romello Taylor. He turns it to Vaughn Hutchinson Jr. into the corner, Makuna. Now to Wilson. Wilson. Up fake, missed off the rim. Cooper.
And there's that second opportunity.
And back out, another opportunity. Now down low. Cooper slams it down for Niagara. And that's one way to finish strong. Kevin Cooper just into the ball game. First 2 points with authority. Kareem Collins at the top. And there's Broad, bodied hard, a little too hard by Cooper. And we'll take another look, though, at that Kevin Cooper slam. Second and third opportunities is what leads to these kind of finishes. And when you give this many opportunities like Mohawk did, eventually you get hurt in that kind of manner.
Get slammed.
And you get dunked on, or slammed, as Sadie likes to say. There's a pass intended for Barr that's knocked right over the head of the Niagara bench. Almost hit our sweet Christine Midgley in the face. But she seems okay. Elcock will inbound again. So as the inbound ready to happen, the referee's just having a little talk with Jonker about his positioning on the sideline.
He's not allowed to run up and down the court, unfortunately.
He's trying to pretty much get his team back in this game, down 14 in the early going here, the second quarter. Barr battling, 5 seconds on the shot, puts up a four shot and hits. Finally, Lamar Barr hits the
scoreboard.
Performing
under pressure.
And an almost steal for Barr, a great read, but he was just a little late. Hutchinson now, Taylor. Driving to the hoop, tries to send it out, and Barr gets his hand on it. A great play by Lamar, and in possession of it, although battled with by two Niagara defenders, he's able to win it, and it will be Mohawk ball from the outside as a foul was called on number one, Romello Taylor. Barr to inbound. Cooper, who had that slam, will come off, and back onto the court will come Vikram Kaley.
Right, left.
Collins driving with speed, and what a step.
He's so fast.
But he could not get the call and was not able to finish at the hoop. Romello Taylor, up fake. Great pass down low to Kaley. He just couldn't get the handle. Now he finds Wilson, and Wilson's shot pops off rim and out. Elcock couldn't get the handle on the rebound. What a spinning pass by Hutchinson Jr. And yet Wilson had it knocked out of his hands as he went up for it. What a terrific skill play there on that pass. There's Gaffer. Great little handoff for Elcock in the corner. He just couldn't get it to fall.
I like how Mohawk's moving right now. They're moving the ball well.
A lot better movement from the Mountaineers, as you say. Taylor up court for Niagara. Been a very pacey game in this first half of play. Hutchinson Jr. sets up. Thought about it. We'll send it over to Makuna. Now to the corner. Vikram Kaley for three and drills it from the corner.
He's left wide open there.
15-point advantage for Niagara College now, their biggest lead in the ballgame. Kareem Collins at the top to Lamar Barr. Barr spinning off. Thought about it, still with the ball. Finally puts his dribble down, gets off the quick
nice
jumper
finish.
And makes. And that's what they'll need. They'll need more from Lamar and more for Kareem Collins.
Yeah, and he's been doing that for them.
On. Down low, Kelly. Tried to get the quick pass to Makuna, knocked out of his hands. A great strip. Now Muhammad Gafer down the right side with a little move. Gafer finds Elcock at the top. Now he goes to Barr. Barr will put up the three. Feeling good, but he's off front rim with it there. Back the other way, it's Taylor now. Taylor against Elcock. Makes a little move off the screen and
easy.
Hits the triple
yeah.
like it's nothing. And Niagara College, just to say this, they are making their shots. Elcock down the other way with an open three. Might have forced it, and it's just in and out. He cannot get a thing to fall for him. And that is some bad luck for Matt Elcock right now. Hutchinson shakes, fakes, tries to find his man inside, but a good cut by Gaffer, able to knock that ball loose away
Niagara,
to the corner.
They're rolling the bodies through, so keeping up their speed. Like you said, this game's been very well paced.
So a couple of changes for either side as we see Hilton back into the game for Niagara College as well as Elliott. And we see Romello Taylor come off to the side to get a break. And there's a pass intended for Elliott, knocked off the fingertips of Jordan Martin, who's back on the court as well for Mohawk. And our first look at Jalen Bailey, who went to the same high school as Kareem Collins and the Gafer brothers. So he knows the teammates quite well.
Back him up, back him up!
See what kind of impact he can have now that he's on the court for the first time this season and in his Mohawk career. And there's a knock away by Bailey, and he's able to win them the ball back by making a smart defensive play off of Vikram Kaley.
Niagara's having a tougher time against Mohawk's defense at this point.
But hasn't had as tough a time as Mohawk against Niagara's defense in the first two quarters thus far. Broad up top. And unfortunately, as he thought about it, did not get the dribble down to match with the feet movement. And he's called on a travel with just 4 minutes to go in this first half of play. Mohawk currently trailing 16 points. Not a usual stat line for the Mohawk Mountaineers to be trailing this much in the ball game. We did not watch them have struggles like this last year all that often. But
it's a very different team this year.
Very different team, as you do say.
A lot of newbies, like Christine said. There's eight that are straight out of high school. I don't know. I think we had one rookie last year, so it was definitely not as young of a team as we have this
time around.
A
much different look this time around for the Mountaineers. Bailey ends up taking the three, did not really get his good setup for that three. Off-balance shot hits backboard and out, and there will be a foul on Niagara College. And it's going to be number 13, Vikram Kaley, with the call on the push-off. And now we will see a substitution. Adrian Achonwa will bring off Jesse Broad, who will get a break. Kareem Collins. And it's worked around at the top. Martin finds Elcock. Elcock thought about it. A little handoff for Kareem Collins.
Nice
Kareem
move.
Collins cutting in. Lays
wow.
it in with the left hand. Great,
great
finish,
finish
by Kareem. Ball the other way. Good play
Look
by Martin
Niagara
to try and get
return.
His hand on it. And he at least put Vine Hutchinson in a tough position. Now Martin the other way. Out of a little control. Finally got a handoff there to Collins. They swing it back to Martin. Pass down low though. Lost, and Hutchinson tried to knock it off Bailey and out of bounds, and Wilson able to pick up for Niagara. Back to Hutchinson Jr., and up ahead it's Elliott. Thought about a quick shot, ends up handing off. Hutchinson Jr., up fake. Now drives and puts up a left hand and will not get the call.
Thank you, Brad.
And there was a blocking foul there called on Achonwa. So two from Hutchinson Jr. at the line as Niagara, who have hit the 40-point plateau before Mohawks hit 30, look to up this lead and add.
I think a lot of what Mohawk has to work on in this game and the games to come is just their team chemistry and figuring out what roles everyone's going to play. I was definitely hoping Matt Elcock would show us one of those 25 or 30-point games, but we still have a lot of game left, so
well,
maybe those threes will start dropping.
Still a whole half to play. And with 2:45 left in this first half, it's been unfortunate, and it's really been a lot of bad luck. It's easy to say that.
A lot of front rim, a lot of back rim.
Oh, it's easy to say that, being that we are Mohawks, obviously broadcasting team, and we are positive people, and we are cheering for the Mountaineers in a small way. But at the same time, having watched them all last year, it's fair to say this has been an unlucky game for even the players, like you said, like Elcock, who have been so close, could have 20 points almost right now, but have had three or four shots just be that close in and out.
Yeah.
And with those three or four shots going the other way, maybe this is a much closer game.
Mm-hmm. And going towards Niagara's defense, though, they play phenomenal defense, so it might just be throwing off our Mohawk shooters just that little fraction that they're not finishing.
And that physical defense from Niagara has not let up all afternoon. And there's a ball knocked loose to the corner. Collins didn't have his foot on the line, and yet the call was made as soon as he touched the ball for out of bounds. Seemed like Collins' foot on the replay, if you could see. We might not be able to get one, but it looked like his foot was inside the black. But on second thought, they're going to call it out of bounds. So Niagara will move forward. Hutchinson Jr. working against Collins. Switching off. Now Elliott driving against Elcock. Gets a foot by him. And on that step, couldn't make anything happen, though. Bailey on the turnover the other way. Coming down court. Had more time to go up strong with it. Put it up a little bit weak in front of Vikram Kaylee. And now back the other way. A three on one.
Wow.
And it's Wilson to the hoop
good
with an easy right-handed lay-in. And that is Niagara showing Mohawk exactly what they should have done. And then, Collins almost picked his pocket. Was Wilson going in for another easy score, but the call made immediately on the hand check foul, and we will see a substitution, a pair for Mohawk, as we're going to see Muhammad Gaffer and Ty Urig come into the game as Collins goes to the line shooting two, as Mohawk with 2:01 to go in the penalty scenario is Niagara. Collins will make the first of two, which brings the lead down 44-27 right now for the Knights. And Collins will make the second. So a 16-point deficit now. Ty Urig in. Achanwall will come off. And we will also see, Achanwall will stay on. We will see Urig come in and Gaffer come in. And we will also see Collins step off, giving him a rest. Here's Wilson to the rim. Great step around on Achanwa. He can't believe there's a call.
Yeah, that looks like it traveled to me a little bit.
And there's been a few questionable decisions by both crews, the referees who were part of the women's game prior to this, and of course tonight in this men's game. But as confusing or possibly inconsistent as they've looked, it is a tough job. So can't say I'd do any better myself.
Yeah, we just sit here and judge them.
We just like to complain.
Criticize every call they make.
I mean, I bet I could shoot a lot better than most of these guys anyways.
Definitely.
But we won't get into that. So the ball will be at the free throw line for Wilson for a technical foul shot. And a technical foul, I believe, as he makes. And now he will shoot one more. That was the technical foul shot on Achanwa. And now this is for the foul on Achanwa and the and one. So two shots. And then, of course, Niagara will keep possession. So this is about as bad as it's gotten for Mohawk here in this first half, as Elliott will miss.
Yeah, Jonker's
the
not
one
too happy.
Technical foul shot, I believe. And now we will see Niagara take it from outside on the sideline. 47-28 for Niagara College. Hutchinson Jr. will inbound.
Rob. Mohawk playing a tight defense.
Laquan Hilton. Now to Hutchinson Jr. again. Bailey up court. Gaffer. Left hand can't finish. Rebound off the backboard and out. And Elliott will bring it forward.
Niagara's a tough team to defend to begin with because they have those outside shooters, and then they also have people like Hutchinson that can take it to the net.
And he has shown no fear in spotting up and shooting as
exactly.
well.
Exactly. He is that all-around player.
Which drags that defense
out. Exactly.
Bad miss there.
Especially with a young team like this, it's hard for them to have to move from inside to outside.
Bad pass from Bailey. Easy interception. Wilson the other way. Hutchinson Jr. Here's a three and missed off the backboard from Laquan Hilton. Back rim and then backboard. And now a foul by Hutchinson Jr. trying to chase down Achanwa. It has not been a good first half for the Mohawk Mountaineers. They trail by 19. They have turned the ball over quite a bit. And not only have they been turning the ball over, but they are not making the shots that they normally do. And those misses have really hurt them and 100%. Dragged them out of this game a bit.
Yeah, and I think for as young of a team as it is, and there were probably a lot of nerves going into this game. We talked about this a little bit earlier with the women's, how it's like the first actual season game. Preseason's a little bit different. There's no pressure, but first season game, especially when you're playing for Mohawk, there's a huge kind of reputation if you watched the team last year to kind of uphold and try to, you know, build off of that.
That miss by Achanwa as he makes only one of two from the free throw line, and it's an 18-point deficit with just 1:05 to go in the first half. Full court press is on, and it's off the hand of Achanwa, and he almost able to win the ball loose. They have to hurry to get over the timeline. They do, and it's still in the hands of Wilson, who goes up strong and can't hit. Still coming down and getting it as Niagara College in the paint and finally losing it out of bounds off a Mohawk hand is Wilson after the miss from Payam Saboni on the rebound.
Once again, we're seeing Niagara dominating
fourth,
those
chances.
Boards.
And it's too many chances.
Way too many.
If you're Mohawk College.
Four, six,
Hilton.
Five.
Shot clock coming down. He knows it. He's going to set up, spot, and shoot, and drill the long-range deuce with time running down. A 20-point lead for Niagara College in the first half on the road at the David Braley Athletic and Recreation Center in Mohawk College. And now a foul that will go against number 7, Laquan Hilton, on the reach in there. And we will see Martin, who might have gotten a little shot to the eye there, go to the line and take his first two free throws. So Martin misses the first. And he'll miss the second as well. Ulrich tipped it, but to no one. Hilton can come the other way. Niagara in the last 25 seconds. And Hilton with a great drive. Can't finish. Rebound is good from Hutchinson Jr. So Mohawk up the court here with the shot clock off. And just 10 seconds to go. And Martin, as he drives, is wrapped up and fouled. Grabbed on his way to the hoop with 11.4 to go.
If you're Niagara, I don't think that's a foul you need to take at this point.
No, but at the same time, Mohawk, as much as they have been driving the net, have not made their shots, and it's even more so a bad foul to take because Niagara really doesn't need to be hacking these Mohawk players when they can't make any shots anyways.
Yeah. Especially with like 11 seconds left. No real chance of Mohawk taking the lead at this point.
And there's a miss from Martin, but he puts in his own rebound, so a couple extra points there to grab after the two misses. 51-31 for Mohawk, and here's a long-range shot, and Hutchinson just misses off rim. 51-31, 20-point deficit at the end of the first half in their season opener and home opener. Smiles all around for Niagara College, and a lot of confused and distraught looks on the Mohawk College Mountaineers bench following the end of this first half of play. 20-point deficit, and as we come to the end of the first half, Christine Midgley, our sideline reporter, is standing alongside with Jeff Hunt, an alumni and former member of the men's basketball team, who is now an assistant coach of this year's squad. Christine.
Hey guys, I'm down here with Mohawk basketball royalty coach Jeff Hunt. Okay, that honestly feels so weird for me to say. It's gotta feel weirder for you. How's the transition been from becoming player to coach?
It's a little different, harder than I thought it would be, but I'm enjoying it. It's good to help the young kids go on and carry on the program and hopefully turn things around and keep things going the right way.
We would hope so. I mean, right now, Junker probably wishes he could throw you in the game. It's been pretty rough. We've got to talk about it. They've been struggling the first half. What do we need to do moving forward to get this game back?
We just need a little more effort, I think, and guys need to be more engaged coming off the bench. We can turn things around, still win this game. Our rebounding has to be a little better, but there's still lots of time, and we're young. We'll have a couple learning curves like this along the way, but we have enough time to win this game still.
Awesome, yeah. Junker said it was going to be a time to grow, so I think that's what we're seeing here. Thanks so much. Good luck in the second half.
No problem.
All right, Nick, take it back to you.
Thank you, Christine. So as we head to halftime, it's 51-31 for Niagara College. And as they take a 20-point lead to the half, we'll leave you with some highlights from the first half of action. And when we return, third quarter action from the David Braley Athletic and Recreation Center at Mohawk. On Embling. Welcome inside the David Braley Athletic and Recreation Center for this second half of play. Nick Burney alongside me, Sadie Martin and Christine Midgley on the touchline, our sideline reporter. As Mohawk starts the second half down 20 points, 51-31 to the Niagara College Knights. A couple things to look at. They were outscored 12-3 on second chance points. They were outdone 12-2 in points in the paint. Total rebounds out-rebounded 32-24 as Elcock begins the quarter by inbounding the pass to Cream Collins. And Sadie, one thing we're looking forward here is for a big bounce back in terms of offense from Mohawk.
That's
coming
out here.
That's
what we're hoping from. Yeah, there's no one really shining on Mohawk's end of things. We have like 9 points and 7 points, 6 points. No one's really taken that shine. On Niagara's end, though, Van Hutchinson, he's had 13 points. So he's definitely their leading scorer on their end.
Big rebound there from Wilson, and he's able to put back another second chance point for Niagara. Give them 14 now to just 4 for Mohawk College on second chance points. Excuse me, just 3 for Mohawk College.
And that's all the problems that we were already talking about, that Niagara's getting so many second and third chances, and that's where they're getting their points from.
And there's a quick shot from the side by Collins. Off rim and out. Board grab by Hutchinson Jr. Ahead. Laquan Hilton, long range three off the front rim. And those shots were falling all first half for Niagara and Hilton. Not there. Here's Barr cutting through, and he traveled too many steps as he tried to get to the rim.
I think there his defenders were backing up on him. I think he should have just like pulled up right around the foul line area, and he would have had that like wide open shot.
And we've seen him make a couple of those pull up shots earlier in the game. Wilson, great pass down low. Vikram Kaley is standing right under the basket. And he was not guarded by anyone in white. Long pass, Barr couldn't handle it, and it's off his fingertips and out of bounds. So, like the first half, Mohawk in a rough spot to start the second half in terms of their consistency with possessions offensively. And like you said, lots to make up for. Started down 20, now down 22. Hutchinson Jr. cutting again, and Van Hutchinson has finished with the left hand with ease in the paint.
Too easy for him.
57-33 Niagara College. Kareem Collins driving. Collins spinning. Outside. Elcock long range triple off front rim. Elcock grabs the board. Cuts in. Leans in. Oh. Can't get to go. Very unlucky on that miss. Down the other way. Laquan Hilton finding Hutchinson jamming towards the net. Doesn't get the call but makes the tough shot under pressure from Collins.
Two quick buckets from
and
Hutchinson.
Keith Vassell couldn't believe the non-call, the Niagara coach. There's a little dribble, and off the knee of Collins, it will go out of bounds and be Mohawk ball on the touchline. They trail by 26 points now. We'll take another replay of that. Should have been foul on Hutchinson as he went up strong with the left hand. Surprisingly, no call on Mohawk's Kareem Collins. But a good finish from Vaughn Hutchinson, and it's been the story of this game as you take another look. A little bit of inconsistent referee play, but a lot of dominance from Niagara down low. There's Barr, turnaround jumper, no good off rim and out.
Mohawk hasn't had a very good day with their shooting.
Back the other way, open three for Laquan Hilton, off rim, no good. Another offensive board from Acuna. And this is just the simple parts of the game beating Mohawk. They are not grabbing those rebounds. No one is working the glass better than the Niagara College forwards and center. So two from the line from Acuna. Levi Acuna, born and raised in Hamilton. in his third year at Niagara College. The only Hamilton native on the Niagara College team, so a homecoming of sorts for Levi. He'll make that and put Niagara into the 60 category of points now. And here's Lamar Barr.
Nice drive.
And he's able to tip back the rebound at least and put it home.
61-35. This is the time that players like Lamar Barr and Kareem Collins need to step up, having been the veterans on this team.
There's a pass down low, inside into Hutchinson, battling, couldn't come up with the ball as he went up with it. Collins back the other way, under pressure, tried to find Broad in the middle, it was off the fingertips of Wilson, hustling back. Good play by Jordan Wilson on the defensive end for Niagara. And Makuna, slow to get up off the floor, took a heavy tumble at the end of that play. Alex Elliott will sub back in, and we will see the sub off of Levi Makuna now to give him a break and a much needed and deserved rest. Collins to inbound. Elcock from the corner, air ball three, comes down off of Broad and through his and Peacock's hands, and it's just been that kind of afternoon for Mohawk. Everything that could go
pretty
wrong
much
has.
Pretty much sums up our first half.
Wilson to Hutchinson Jr. And he stepped on the line. Nope, we're going to see a foul on Kareem Collins on the push.
I think that was a little soft.
And another pretty soft call. And most have been on full court presses, I've noticed. Quite a few soft calls from the referees allowed on both ends. Hutchinson Jr. again, working on Collins. Collins with good body defense, threw him into his own man, Wilson. And again, we're going to see a foul on Collins.
Really? But isn't that what a pick
and
is
I
for?
And I believe that is a foolish call to make, considering Kareem had nothing more he could do than drive through the pick as he did. Watson
usually you're
the
there to absorb the pick. That's
Wilson absorbed the pick, like you said. And yet still, Kareem drawing the foul. They're going to say that it was a push in the back on Hutchinson, I believe. So some iffy calls that are just not going the way of Mohawk College at this point in time.
Make it a little bit more difficult for this comeback.
So here is Hilton, Laquan Hilton, down low. His pass went through and off of Peacock, up through the net, and then back down through. And that was tipped by White, so it will be Niagara College ball from the baseline as an out-of-bounds.
I think the coach is trying to sway that vote.
And Keith Vassell was trying to sway that vote for 2 points there. Didn't even want the possession. Hilton in the middle, turned over. Peacock, though, didn't get far with it. But Hutchinson Jr., who can't believe it as he comes flying over the sideline, is going to get called on the reach-in foul.
I think that's a fair call.
That was a pretty iffy call, even in my book. Sadie doesn't agree.
I don't think so.
But Sadie's always cheering for the Mountaineers, and that's more than fine with me. Kareem Collins down to the corner. Barr launches a quick three. He came up short with it, not enough on it. And that has been the story for Mohawk all night. They've just been that much off on everything. Hutchinson on the flying alley-oop just tried to keep it in play, and he lands out of bounds. So Barty inbound to Collins here, and Mohawk will start. 6:20 and counting in the third quarter. Lots of time left in this game, but the lead is 26. Elcock. Inside, left-handed move. Great take by Matt Elcock. We have not seen him drive the rim a whole lot. But that was good to see from Matt, who led them in scoring in their last three preseason games, but has not had the same opening night as he or his teammates would have hoped to this point in time. Hilton up top. It gets passed around from Wilson to Elliott. Elliott looking inside, trying to find Hutchinson. Does. Pass gets down low to him. We're going to see a foul called here. And it's going to be, Jesse Broad taking the foul call there. He joined Collins down low on the block trying to handle Hutchinson. And with that, we will see some substitutions as Elcock will come off. And we will see Achonwa as well come in. Lamar Barr coming off for a much-needed rest. And Kareem Collins staying on. And here's a long-range three off the quick inbounds pass. Elliott off front rim.
Niagara
now
fighting
Achonwa
for that ball.
Can't win the ball And the loose ball picked up by Saboni, then he lost it, then it was off the fingertips of Elliott Saboni for Niagara, and it'll be Mohawk ball. But the hustle and the hustle plays have been there for Niagara College much and farther often than Mohawk. Full court press still on from Niagara. Peacock and Martin coming back to the ball. On the inbounds. Martin. Little alley-oop to space. Peacock ended up finding it. Kept it in. Great play to save it. Martin drops it off. Collins thought about it. Now to Martin. Jordan Martin again. Now tried to get a pass before he hit the ground. He just did. And the rebound, Muhammad Gaffer tried to tip it back up. Was not very strong on it, but he'll earn the call. So the call against Niagara and following it, a pair of free throws for Muhammad Gaffer. We have not seen Ahmed, his brother, appear in the game today yet. This is for Muhammad, his first appearance in Mohawk Mountaineer basketball colors. And as we've said that for many different players tonight, including Matt Elcock and Jordan Martin, who are, and the of course, also Ty Urig.
There's a lot. You have to go down the roster list for all the rookies.
Too many to count for Brian Jonker's side as we begin play today.
Yeah, it's a bonus. Isn't this saying that it's bonus for us?
So, or is that, with the foul being called, the referee's trying to
I think there's been
agree,
a
and
of
I believe
a mix
they,
up on
they
bonus.
Thought it was in the bonus, and it turns out it is. In the bonus. So Mohawk will go to the line.
Niagara will go to the line.
Or excuse me, it will be Niagara going to the line.
Mohawk,
because of
that
foul.
Not another good situation.
Looked like that call was actually going Mohawk's way originally, but because of this, and Mohawk, of course, as mentioned, in the penalty scenario now, Niagara in the bonus. Every foul will take them to the free throw line with 5:14 to play in the third quarter. Lots of time, too much time for every foul to lead to that end result. Mohawk moving quickly the other way on a turnover. Now Collins to the hoop, and he will finish strong.
Kareem Collins, he has such like a stride on him. I thought that was going to go right by him, but he was able to scoop it up and finish that.
And Collins showing his fleet of foot. Now Hutchinson from the sideline took about three steps and exploded through that rim.
You saw there was a little bit of a confusion of who was guarding him.
That was a slam if you've ever seen one. Left-handed throwdown. And Hutchinson making it look too easy.
And that'll bring him to 20 points.
We got
to
take another look at that slam from the Niagara College forward.
On who was defending him, and then he just took that as an opportunity.
One step, that's all it took. Blew by his defender, and then a couple more to launch pad him up to where the net was. He got his head almost at net rim on that one. Big slam from Hutchinson. Back the other way comes Niagara College, and Saboni fighting through will earn the call against Achonwa, who's had a frustrating afternoon for Mohawk.
A lot of fouls on Mohawk's end of things.
And it's been a rough start for the Mohawk Mountaineers in their season opener and home opener. Has not gone the way they had hoped. Not even close to this point, trailing 64-41 with 4:34 to go in the third quarter of play. And the first shot, an air ball from Saboni on the free throw. That gives the crowd a little something to cheer about. It's about the first thing they've had to cheer about in the entirety of this basketball game to this point. Misses the second. Quickly back up the court. Greer gets the lay-in, a quick couple points. And it's a 21-point game as Niagara slowly having their lead chipped away at. And the full court press leads to another turnover. Muhammad Gaffer going in again.
It's calling the foul.
And Gaffer, I'm not 100% sure how to pronounce his name, but he definitely knows how to pronounce defense, because that's one thing he knows pretty well. That was my best attempt at a joke.
Wow, that was really cheesy.
21-point deficit for Mohawk Mountaineers as we head to a break. 4:18 to go, third quarter of play. And Me and Sadie have been peering over the stat sheets through the first three quarters, or most of three quarters of play, and some very noticeable stat lines. Van Hutchinson Jr. has had his way on the points. And
yeah,
in regards,
20.
Exactly, and in regards to the three-point line, Laquan Hilton, 3 of 4 from beyond the arc. For Mohawk, Kareem Collins has sort of put together a game that has shown flashes of what could be, but like Lamar Barr and like, unfortunately, Matt Elkoff, everything that could go wrong has seemed to go wrong.
Well, I think
Mohawk.
And what's different now is last year the Mohawk team, there were so many players that could pull out 20-plus games any given time that they – every game we went to, there would be 3 or 4 players. They weren't usually the same 3 or 4 players, but there was always someone pulling out those big points. Now it's kind of been put on the veteran shoulders that you have to perform every single game because we don't have, you know, Matt Fennell and Jeff Hunt and people like that to back up those scoring. And I think the pressure has, I think it's definitely felt across the veterans having to kind of hold the glue together of this new team.
And I've noticed one thing that shouldn't disappoint Mohawk fans just yet, but should be something to keep an eye on. This Mohawk Mountaineers team has not done a very good job down low in the paint on their own defensive end and in the offensive end. They've given up way too many offensive rebounds, way too many second chance points, and if that's something that'll continue further this year, that'll be a big problem for Coach Brian Jonker. This is definitely a smaller squad. As you've mentioned, different players, different squad, also a smaller built squad than in years past.
In any college team, if you give them second and third opportunities at this level, you're going to get blown out.
Almost a travel, and now a travel is called on Payam Saboni. Looked like Van Hutchinson Jr. had done the same just seconds before, but either way, it'll be Mohawk ball off on the sideline. Another turnover from Niagara, and suddenly this has gone from a 26-point game to a 20-point game real quick. Kareem Collins to inbound, looking for Martin. Now looks down low instead. Finds Peacock, quick three, does not go, but Achonwa with a good offensive board. Finding Collins in the paint, and he gets it up, and he's fouled on his way up. And he will go for two now. Kareem Collins has been one of the few guys who looks like he's got his feet under him, at least running-wise, but his shot hasn't been there either. And like we just said, he, Barr, and Elcock have just had the worst of luck today. But still, with 4:05 to go third quarter and a full 10 minutes and fourth quarter remaining, there's enough time Mohawk can cut this 20-point deficit down and still make a comeback here. They just need to put a charge together. First shot, though, missed by Collins.
For sure, and Kareem Collins, he's so fast. So if you have him on the court, you want to be hitting him on fast break opportunities any chance you can get. Especially with the refs, they're calling a lot of fouls.
And like you say, the referees in the women's game prior and this men's game have been very involved, using the whistle quite a few times more than we even expected in a few different scenarios. And there's been a lot of travel calls in this first game for either side. There's a good rebound on the offensive end from Wilson. Good little feed to Elliott. He could not put in the loose ball, though. Now a feed the other way. Mohammed Yaffer finds Jordan Martin. And that's a nice, easy finish. We're under 20 points. It's now a 17-point lead for Niagara. And there, Elliott losing it on the touch, out of bounds.
Mohawks are getting a little amped up right now. I think
another
there's
turnover.
Been a little bit of a shift.
And the ball, out of bounds off of a quick rush from Niagara, is a third straight turnover on their third straight possession. Mm-hmm. So
the Niagara coach, he just said, you know, keep it simple.
And you can see
been a couple
Keith Vassell's point is, let's slow down, let's stay focused and controlled. It may be a 15-plus point lead, but there is too much time left to start
to let it go
playing
now.
Around as if this is street ball. And there's Martin losing the handle. Great dive from Elcock, finds the ball, gets it back now to Martin in the corner. He turns it to Elcock, thought about the three, up fake again. He's stuck.
There's 5 seconds.
And his pass is picked. Vaughn Hutchinson on the run, and a great layup. Looked for the call, made it even harder on himself, and still found a way to finish. Elcock to Martin. Martin driving the hoop, now finds Peacock on the outside for three, and he's off front rim, but Martin grabs the board, and he's way too hard with the finish. And the loose ball from Wilson, thrown out ahead. They have numbers on the run. Laquan Hilton, instead of placing up a three, will slow things down. Smart play from the point man. Wilson tried to find Vaughn Hutchinson Jr. down low, was a little too far ahead on the lead pass. So Lamar Barr and Ty Urig will come back into the game from Mohawk College. Jordan Martin, who had a very good run of play there, helping the team pick up some points and cut into the deficit, will take a much-deserved break. 66-47, 19 points. Still the deficit for Mohawk College, but they've gotten it under 20, and that's got to be good news for right now. Barr, off to the side. Barr, taking a long time, adjusting, finds Elcock on the swing-around play, drills the turnaround jumper. It looks like a long two is how they will rate it. 17-point game now, 66-49.
And we just need Mohawk to start making those shots. We've seen a lot of misses, but
and
close
Hutchinson
misses.
Hutchinson Jr. is going to end up trying to find Wilson down low, and it's going to be Wilson who gets called on the body. So Jordan Wilson called on the foul.
That's his third foul.
And it's his third personal foul on the play.
He was talking to me.
And now we're going to get a technical, I believe. And Keith Vassell is not very pleased because it looked like Jordan Wilson
wasn't even making
conversation with any of the referees and was actually talking to his coach. And now the claim is that it'd be a technical foul for the argument that Wilson was putting up. And Vassell has put up just as much argument. So if Wilson didn't earn the technical, his coach might have. Matt Elcock with the miss on the technical foul. And Elcock will now have Barr inbounding to him on the sideline. And it's a 17-point deficit. And Keith Vassell not pleased with the refereeing, and he has every right to be. It's been a pretty up and down, inconsistent affair from the refs tonight. Elcock up top. Gaffer shot doesn't go. Loose ball foul on Niagara College. And this has been what Mohawk has missed all day till this point. Second chance points for themselves, an extra effort down low getting them the offensive boards, something Niagara has done all afternoon against them with
ease. Exactly, yeah, and Mohawk needs these. This is the stuff that boosts your confidence.
First shot made by Peacock. Jared in his first game with the team, first as a Mountaineer. And he'll make his second. 66-51, 15-point game after the two free throws went down for Peacock. Still a close game.
I think if Mohawk, you know, keeps the pressure on and...
As Mohawk starts to chip away, and Barr has it go off his hands, another steal. Now Elcock with it. Under a minute, 45 to go, third quarter. Elcock with a lot of free lane goes right at Romello Taylor. And Taylor does not like the call. But Elcock will go to the line for two. He was held on the play. And Taylor having a little word with the referee, definitely didn't agree and has a few choice words for him possibly. First goes down for Elcock. And he also hits on the second, 66-53.
So Elcock now has 12 points for himself.
And Matt.
Definitely picking it up this period.
As you mentioned, picking up his point total, along with the team picking up their sense of urgency. Clearly the defense on in terms of pressure has raised.
And Mohawk has been slowly creeping
in. And there another pick almost. Loose ball picked up, driven to the net by Lamar Copeland, and a foul called.
Oh,
and it's
charge.
An offensive foul. A charge on Copeland as Elcock able to stand in front and take the charge. Solid job from the Mohawk point guard. And we are going to see a timeout call by Niagara College. 66-53. We'll take a look at that foul that just happened there. Great charge taken by Matt Elcock, who you were just saying was getting it done on the offensive end. Now he's turning it in on the defensive end as well. Just great job setting the feet. You can see a little argument from the Niagara coaches, but
I
think he was outside. I think he was outside of the umbrella. So,
well, you know, if you're a player, you know how to, you know, amp up the drama when you need to. And especially if you're going for a charge, you got to fall backwards or else they're not going to call it. So.
And the lead that was once 26 points is cut in half to 13, 66-53.
Yeah, we've seen a change. I think the big change has been the second chance points. Like from Niagara at the half, they had 12 second chance points and Mohawk only had 3. Obviously, those numbers have changed. I think Mohawk's doing a better job getting the rebounds offensively and defensively. They're getting more of them, and they're not giving Niagara those second and third and fourth and fifth opportunities.
And that's the other thing. We haven't noticed a whole lot of pressure from Niagara on the boards like they were in the first half offensively. There hasn't been the same amount of offensive rebounds. So
no, definitely not.
Mohawk has closed it up defensively a whole lot, which is really the key here. Yes, the offense need to get going, but they need to put a stop to Niagara, and they surely have slowed down this offense. 66-53, a minute 16 to play, third quarter from the David Braley Athletic and Recreation Center on Mohawk College campus. You are watching Mohawk Mountaineers basketball on M-Link, and now, unfortunately,
charge.
A charge called the other way. Elcock thought he had earned that and thought that he had gotten his shot to go, but unfortunately, great setup there from the Niagara defense, and we'll take another look quickly as Taylor inbounds. A quick look at that last drive, and very close call, but Vikram Kaylee looked like he got his legs
set. It looked like there was
set.
Someone else kind of on his side too, though, so I can see where either foul would be called.
And there, Ty Ugrig able to grab that board, the miss off the side, and now picked up, thrown back to the top, it's Elcock. From Peacock.
Only 40 seconds left in this quarter.
With time running. Barr, quick turnaround shot. Off rim, doesn't go, and the loose ball picked up and rebounded by Payam Saboni. Brought forward by Niagara. Finds Romello Taylor. Taylor with Barr all over him. Finds Makuna at the top. Just
the
18 seconds. Shot clock
nine.
Under 10. And now a foul. A bad foul to give from Mohawk with just 15.8 to go and 8 seconds left in the shot clock, and they will send, Levi Makuna, the Hamilton native, to the line for Niagara. 15.8 seconds left. And we'll take a look following that first free throw shot going down at the foul. And you can see just
there's
the elbow of Ugrig.
Elbow there.
Extending, and that was too easy for the referees to miss.
And
so he makes both, and at 68-53, we now have a push-off
bonus.
Foul here and a double bonus for Mohawk. So Elcock will go right down to the other end of the court, and he'll go to the free throw line here for the Mountaineers.
And on the one hand, it's not a spot Mohawk wants to be in with Niagara in bonus, but at the same time, they're also in bonus, so I guess it kind of works for and against them.
And Elcock able to hit the first.
He's had a much better quarter, scoring 2-4.
Much better quarter overall for the Mountaineers
eight.
As he makes both free throws.
Yeah, Matt Elcock has scored 8 points just in this quarter alone. More of the play that we were expecting to see from him this game.
Taylor right to the hoop, though. No one there. And unfortunately, Mohawk's defense breaks down again. And the lead back up to 15. And as the half ends on that long-range attempt from Elcock, Niagara College has managed to maintain their lead, a pretty hefty one, 70-55 through three quarters of play. And as we end three quarters, one of the main pieces for Niagara College has been Van Hutchinson Jr., who has been off and on fire in terms of his offensive play. And as you can see, quite a few skillful shots made here as you look at some of his best highlights through the first three quarters, including that slam. And realistically, the issue with Van Hutchinson Jr. is his length, his speed with that length, and the fact that he's willing to go outside atop the key and then go all the way and cut down to the hoop. He's a very agile and rangy
player. He can
rebound,
he can shoot the three-pointers, he can drive, he can attack.
And he's made it tough all night.
Definitely like your triple threat player.
He has not made things easy on Mohawk College in the lease tonight, and there's been one issue for Mohawk College guarding him. It's finding someone to match up against him. They have tried, I think, every one of their starters on the court against him, and not one person has seemed to find a way to shut him down.
I think someone that would suit up well against him is actually Kareem Collins, just because he has the same speed as him, and I think that's kind of the main problem with Hutchinson, is once you get him on a fast break, it's kind of game over at that point. So you can keep Collins on him and almost make it he's not allowed to touch the ball.
And
keep
even
him that locked down.
And even as you mentioned, Collins, who would be a great option in terms of his speed and his agility to match Hutchinson's speed and agility. Hutchinson has that height advantage of 6'4", and Collins being only 6 feet. There's not many Mohawk Mountaineers basketball players right now who are 6'4 with the same speed and fitness level of a Van Hutchinson. So he's definitely been the key piece and the reason Niagara has this 15-point lead. As we come to the start of the fourth quarter, where we will see Niagara begin with possession after winning the opening tip. And as we get inbounded, it's Saboni finding Hutchinson Jr.
Just get to the slot.
Hutchinson Jr.
Bam,
on the side. Trying to spin loose, and he gets a travel called against him. Hutchinson went into the paint, looked confident with his move, but unfortunately there, getting called for the extra step. Collins to Barr. Lamar Barr over the timeline for Mohawk. Looking inside, Jesse Broad at the top of the free throw line. Hands off, Collins tried to drive with the left and got taken away. Rebound by Saboni. Ahead, it's Romello Taylor. Romello Taylor hands off to Makuna, back to Taylor, triple off the back iron and out, and the rebound comes down to Collins as he runs the other way. Collins trying to slow down, feeds Barr, open three, and he's in and out. Nothing goes down for the Mountaineers tonight, and the loose board rebound can't be put up and in by Broad, and the foul, or excuse me, eventually called out of bounds on Niagara, and excuse me, that was Peacock who missed on the putback.
We were talking about earlier how Mohawk stepped up their defense and they're getting those defensive rebounds. Just looking at the stats from the third quarter, at half, Niagara had 12 points off of second chance points, and now they're only up to 14. So only one basket that they earned off of second chances, which really shows that Mohawk stepped up their defensive boards.
And as you say that, another miss and a defensive board this time from Niagara College. And Romello Taylor with a quick running right-handed shot in the lane, and the runner in the lane does not go. Lamar Barr the other way. Great move behind the back. Coming up the court and finishing with strength off the glass. Terrific finish from Lamar Barr.
That puts him up to 8 points for this game.
And as the ball is spread up the court the other way with speed, Niagara College will unfortunately still keep possession as it's tipped out of bounds. Ball to be inbounded by Levi Makuna. Back at the top of the key. Niagara College working from the top of the arc. Taylor almost took an extra step, but found Saboni, who couldn't keep it in. Brought his pass way too far over the head of Collins. And it was knocked out of bounds, and there's a bit of confusion, and there'll be a full reset on the 24 seconds there because of the possession that Mohawk had at one point in time there. Vaughn Hutchinson Jr. right in front of us, under pressure, loses it to Peacock. Jared Peacock thought about it, passes it off to Elcock, and he earned the call, although Hutchinson swallowed him whole on that layup attempt. And that's part of the issue with Vaughn Hutchinson Jr. With his length and speed, he's going to be able to get to one end of the court to the other very fleet of foot, and he will be able to catch up to those smaller guards and run them down.
Which is why it's a shame that Mohawk's shot isn't as good as
what
we had hoped.
Lately.
Yeah.
Mm. Definitely not on today. And Elcock able to make the first, or excuse me, yes, Elcock making the first of two from the free throw line. He's had a pretty solid first game as a Mohawk Mountaineer in the
OCAA
season.
Yeah, the first quarter wasn't his best, but he's definitely picked it up. Now he's at 16 points for the game, so it's pretty good. Pretty good first game for a rookie.
It's still a game here. 70-59, 8 minutes to play. It's only an 11-point game.
Yeah, Mohawk has really
closed the gap, but Niagara
still in front,
and there's a great pass, but they will, unfortunately, Mohawk almost had the interception. Barr called on the foul, though, for the chop on the hand check. So Payam Saboni will go to the line, shooting two for Niagara with just under eight to play. The Mohawk comeback has continuously, over the past quarter and a half, chipped away at this lead and brought it down from 26 all the way to what was 11 a second ago, and now back up to 12. Saboni makes both, and it's a 13-point Niagara lead. Kareem Collins coming forward. Collins. Little stop, turn, and Peacock will reset it from the top. Lamar Barr asking for movement.
Down to
shot
10.
Clock under 10. Jesse Broad. Turn around, quick, two, off front rim, no.
Lamar
Barr grabs the board.
It.
Little quick dribble and puts it up strong, but can't get the finish. And the rebound by Kaylee. Out to Laquan Hilton, up the timeline and into Levi Makuna. Back to Hilton. Hilton asking for some calm, controlled play on the offense from Niagara. Hutchinson finds Hilton. Hilton swinging across. Working on Elcock, one-on-one, going up and in, tried to throw it up. Ends up being picked up by Makuna, who backs himself in. His shot, no. Rebound, Saboni finishes. Great finish.
Those are the second opportunities Saboni. That Mohawk can't be letting happen.
Kareem Collins, handoff, Elcock, long-range triple. Got it! And Elcock able to nail the three. Cuts it within 12, keeping Mohawk within it. Every time they've fallen a little bit out of it, they have scratched back and made it closer.
Someone needs to get on.
Vikram Kaylee to Hutchinson. Cutting through, shot no good. Broad the rebound. Elcock comes forward. Matt Elcock over the timeline, looking. Has Barr working against Hilton in a little bit of a mismatch. Now to the corner for Broad. Inside to Barr on the mismatch with Hilton. Down low, he kicks it out. Peacock, open three, off the front rim, just missed. So close to burying a huge three-point shot there was the youngster Jared
Peacock.
Three
pointers would be huge at this point for Mohawk.
Van Hutchinson Jr. from the top. Picks up his dribble, finds Payam Saboni. Now Hilton at the top, working on Elcock. Now he has Makuna working on Barr from the top.
Down to four.
Pick and roll. Makuna shoots with a hand in his face. Air balls it, and the shot clock goes off, but it's Mohawk possession. Barr forward. Picked off by Hutchinson. A bad pass by Lamar Barr. And Hutchinson can't finish over Barr. Great defense by Lamar. Peacock to Collins. It's definitely been a pacey fourth quarter. Elcock from the corner. Oh, just misses a three there. Off the rim, rolling out. Hilton the other way. Back up court, Laquan Hilton into the paint. Runner, good. Great shot
right
from
over
Hilton.
Three players.
76-62. Niagara now in front by 14 with just 5:15 to play fourth quarter in the season opener from the David Braley Athletic and Recreation Center on Mohawk College campus. Lamar Barr still trying for the inside. Tried to find Broad, and the pass was nowhere to be seen. Broad was not expecting. And we will see a timeout called. And I believe we will see a timeout for Mohawk. 76-62, Niagara College, the Knights lead by 14. The lead cut down as low as 11 and has been raised back up a bit by Niagara College since they allowed Mohawk back into the game. With just 5 minutes to go, though, there's still a chance for Mohawk. But they just got to get the three-pointer game back, and they really just have to focus in and understand that what they have to do is play their game and not overdo things.
It's really deep. But
that is exactly what
profound.
We're here for deep and profound knowledge that will bring you closer to the action.
But I think definitely Mohawk, it's the second chance points that are really killing them on Niagara's end, and especially when you have someone like Hutchinson. If you're leaving him open to grab rebounds, it's easy 2 points for him to pop them back in.
And one of the things that we've noticed from Mohawk in this game, which has been sort of disappointing and not the most hopeful going forward, has been the unfortunate out-dueling that Niagara has done of them on the boards, whether it's been offensive or defensive rebounding. I'm not saying that this will be a problem all year, but the way this game has gone, there has been very little improvement in those areas, and that's been an issue that seemingly has kept this deficit at least 10 points minimum throughout this game.
Yeah, and that's just hustle play. Niagara's, they're exactly. Kind of out hustling them for those boards.
And that's kind of a shame when you know that it's a hustle play that is beating the team, because right now, those early moments in the game where they were being outworked has come back to haunt them still. Lots of full
Seeing
court
press. Yeah, from Mohawk.
From Mohawk with some new faces on the court. Four new substitutions to try and give them some life here. And a great block from behind by Jordan Martin. Laquan Hilton does not like the non-call.
And Martin, he's been kind of the spur of energy. Anytime a big play happens, I'm kind of seeing Martin on the
And Martin may not have done a whole lot on the offensive end, but his defense and his prowess on defense against the smaller other guards has definitely been a key for Mohawk staying in this game. There's a miss on an air ball. Achonwa taking it forward, and he finds Jalen Bailey. Bailey, one of the newcomers, great swing pass across to Muhammad Gaffer. He tries to find Bailey again outside. Bailey cuts in, spin around
nice
under the net, and a great lane, but it doesn't go.
It's a
great move, just wouldn't go for Bailey. Van Hutchinson Jr. finds Wilson back up top. Laquan Hilton trying to slow it down here, and he's fouled by Martin, who let him by on that first step.
That's only his first personal foul.
Martin has been pretty solid on defense, one of the few times he's really been beaten or even blown by in this game. Hilton has found it tough when he's on the court to get any offense going. Makuna from the corner. Working on Muhammad Gaffer, and he will get the call and the make, and he'll go to the line, shooting one.
That was well-deserved. There was no help defense there once he got by his one man.
And once he blew by him on the baseline, it was an easy two. So with 4:08 to go, the lead has been pushed to 16. Take another look at that drive by Makuna, the Hamilton native, who beat his man, Muhammad Gaffer, towards the baseline on a great dribble with his left hand, and then came up and under with a little scoop lay-in. Well done. Getting the harm and the hoop. A little cleaning job being done on the floor right now, just prior to the free throws from Makuna. Makuna missing off rim.
Yeah, let's go defense.
And Martin brings forward. So Jordan Martin coming forward now. Looking into the middle. Hits Elcock, and Elcock just could not do a thing with it. He looks a little banged up on his right knee as he comes back up the court. And Niagara moves forward. Makuna lost the ball down low, and then it was lost by Von Hutchinson, and they will say out of bounds. No foul on the play. So, as we'll have a little clean of the court again, some substitutions for both sides. Mohawk bringing back on Lamar Barr, bringing back on Kareem Collins, and Jared Peacock. Score is 78-62 right now for Niagara College.
Just 3.5 minutes left in the game.
3:48 to play.
Ox, you have 23. Know that he wants to catch and shoot.
So Peacock will inbound to Collins, and Collins will take his time to allow this clock to give Mohawk as much time as possible in this game. Collins waiting, Peacock backing into an opponent, turning, handoff, Elcock thought about it, does not have a shot, now thought about it again, picked up his dribble though. Barr, under 10 on the shot clock, trying to make something happen, drives in, feeds inside,
nice
and Peacock was there, great finish. 78-64, Mohawk trail by 14 points.
I thought Lamar might have taken that
Their
one
full
himself.
Court press, though, not looking so good.
Let's go.
Allowing Niagara easily up the court here with about 3 minutes and counting here in the fourth quarter to go. Ben Hutchinson Jr.
Good defense by Collins.
Little handoff. Wilson hands off to Makuna, and he's bumped as he went up and could not get the shot off, but he will go to the line for two.
And that's
Peacock.
Fourth foul.
Coming near fouling out of this one in his debut with Mohawk. We will now also see Payam Saboni check back into the game. And I believe Vikram Kaylee will be the one to substitute out for Niagara College. Second shot from Makuna. Both don't go. Rebound, though, by Wilson. And again, like you said, the boards have cost them, and Levi Makuna really hurt him there. Big slam from the short side jump on the baseline. And that pass into the corner bar, out crop.
Nice
and now
passing.
Elcock able to launch a three, and he cannot hit. Collins, though, able to grab the board at least. Peacock from the top, he launches a quick three and does not hit. Elcock, though, grabs the rebound. No call. He went up, thought he got hacked, and back the other way. And I believe we're going to get a whistle due to an injury. Jordan Wilson didn't want to come off and still doesn't want to come off, but the referee blew it down either way. And he's going to have to come off, is what the referees are alerting the Niagara College staff right now. Wilson took a jab to the leg, clearly right in the Charlie horse area, or maybe even more personal and worse, but either way, he's coming off. So a substitute onto the court now. Back on is Kevin Cooper, who had an earlier slam for Niagara College in his very short time on the court. 80-64 is our score right now. Fourth quarter, 2:32 to go from the David Braley Athletic and Recreation Center on Mohawk College campus. Levi Makuna, open three, too hard, off rim, and they will say last touch by Kevin Cooper, and out of bounds, Mohawk ball. Lamar Barr doing a little cleaning prior to the play beginning.
So, Baba, don't make it easy, but don't let him catch it long.
Everything helps.
Hopefully it will. Mohawk will need a lot of help trailing 16 right now with just 2.5 to go.
Yep.
They are quite a ways away from making a comeback here in this one. They were on their way to a comeback. And all of 4 minutes ago were 11 points down, but Niagara College has turned it up since then, and there's Barr with a great drive. He'll get the call, albeit he won't be able to finish. And we are going to see the quick return of Jordan Wilson back onto the court.
I think that was his
for Niagara
foul.
College. And I.
Kevin Cooper's.
And Cooper.
The foul.
Will already make his fifth foul and will be subbed off. That will be the end of his first, or excuse me, his second game of the season now for Cooper, who leaves having gotten already himself into the highlight package with a beautiful slam dunk earlier in this ball game. There's Barr making the first of two from the free throw line. Second shot good from Barr, 80-66, the score line right now. Niagara in front by 14 points still. Hutchinson Jr., as they try to waste some clock. Wilson just swinging it around now. Laquai Hilton. To Hutchinson Jr., pushed hard by Elcock, no call. Good defense by Mohawk, but Hutchinson Jr., when he wants to, just going to the rim, and eventually, after two more offensive boards. Those extra attempts come back to cost Mohawk College. And now, even though the foul called on Hutchinson, clearly Niagara College starting to move away with this one. 82-66, 16-point advantage with 1:41 to play, fourth quarter.
We're having a lot of sweat cleanup today.
Never before have I seen this much sweat on the floor. We've never had three or four sweat cleanups before here on M-Link. We should really get a Swiffer Wet Jet commercial so we could run an ad in this point in time and just bring people A little bit of the feel we get being down here. We could get I would really like if we get a Bud Light commercial during these kind of times, but I imagine that I don't get any say in these kind of things. My producer is telling me in my ear set that if I don't stop I might not come back. So that's the end of that. Jesse Broad down the other way and able to hit a quick, easy lay-in.
You don't do this for your jokes.
Clearly my jokes are not helping this team win, so we'll have to put an end to them. Makuna back out to the top. It's Hilton. Hilton waiting, trying to waste some time. Under 10 on the shot clock, and the pass redirected out of bounds. And with a minute 20 to go, and just 6 on the shot clock, Niagara remains in possession. Ball up to the top, Jordan Wilson. Quick shot, doesn't go. Jordan Peacock, or Jared Peacock, with the rebound. Up ahead, it's Elcock. Matt driving and getting the call as he goes up and hits, and it's 82-70 now, and a 12-point game.
We're seeing that's his 21 points for Matt Elcock.
And if Elcock has anything to do about it, he is not letting this game end where it's at right now. Not without Mohawk making a push. Elcock drills. So it's 82-71. 11 points, the shortest the deficit has been for Mohawk this game in a long time. Matching the lowest this lead's been all game for Niagara College. And after that block out of bounds, it will still be Niagara College ball. A minute 4 to go. Mohawk need the full court press to be on here and the defense to be stout, but there's an easy inbounds to Jordan Wilson.
Looks like the coach wants them to take all the time for this play, wind the clock down.
Laquan Hilton trying to find his man in the corner. He does. Open three, and that just does not fall. But the loose ball out of bounds off Niagara. Maybe a little bit of a lucky call for Mohawk there. Looked like it might have hit bar last. 50.6 seconds left. Timeout called by the home side as Mohawk down 11. Look to try and set up a little rally. And if they are going to get any sort of rally going, like we said, the boards need to be picked up. They need to not only get those stops, but they need to not allow another second chance point, because at this point in time, too much time coming off the clock with the shot clock.
Exactly. Maybe Jonker's giving them a different play to try right now. You know, when you get into those tougher game decisions, when, you know, it's a much closer game and you're having to throw new plays at them, maybe he wants to give it a try and see how they can work with something that they're just thrown into right away.
One of the things that I've noticed about this game that has been a slight disappointment for Jonker, because aside from the fact his team's losing and it will be disappointing to lose in general, I think he's got to be a little disappointed with that second effort. Because the second effort chance, points, obviously the rebounds, they are being really outdone in both categories.
They just got too far behind early on. Like, we did see a little bit of a shift where they didn't allow as many second chance points for Niagara, but it was kind of too little too late at that point.
And even then, in this fourth quarter, when they've had their run going, we still see a couple times that they just 3 and 4 and 5 chances after the first opportunity.
Exactly.
And that's something Brian Jonker will not allow the rest of the way this season, I guarantee it.
They need to get their rebounding position. Especially, we've seen a lot off of Niagara's foul shots, which is, you already have the position. You already have the advantage. So it's almost a little bit embarrassing.
So the effort needs to be turned up. Cream Collins. Inbound pass is intercepted. And now just able to get back in time is Collins and stop a fast break chance the other way for Niagara. And Niagara College will inbound from the baseline with 20 seconds on the shot clock and 46.4 in the game. An 11-point lead. Quick inbounds, Van Hutchinson Jr. No foul from Mohawk just yet. Going for the steal, could not get it. Makuna will leave it off to Hilton. 15 seconds left on
the
shot clock. Trying to wear down this clock. Now here's Vaughn Hutchinson down low, and he wanted the foul, won't get it, but still makes the great hanging shot.
Still makes it look easy.
And we're under 30 seconds left. Elcock the other way, quick leaning two, and he will hit with 24.9 left. It's 84-71. And a little battle here between Peacock and Hilton, and Elcock wanted the jump ball, but there will be... And it will be a jump ball call. He gets the call for Mohawk. And they will have possession down in the Niagara end with 21.9 to go. Jesse Broad being substituted in along with Mohammed Gaffer.
Guys, switch on the
Kareem Collins. Elcock and Lamar Barr. Jared Peacock coming off. Barr, Elcock on the spinning three, doesn't go. There's Collins, though, able to grab the board, feeds it out. Barr, long range triple, rushing it just a little too hard. And the loose ball rebound is finally in possession of Niagara College. And back the other way they come, and fouled is Hutchinson with just 4.6 to go, and that is going to do it. Niagara College is going to win on the road their second straight to start the season. Meanwhile, Mohawk College will drop their home opener. Excuse me, Niagara, who lost their opener, actually, sorry, at home against Sheridan, will be winning their first road game of the year to move to 1-1. And for Mohawk, this will be their first loss of the season in their first match. First shot missed.
I think that Mohawk has a lot of developing to do, though. I think that, you know, having eight players straight out of high school, there's a lot of chemistry to build off of, and probably a lot of plays and a lot of different stuff that they're having to learn. I think getting this first game out of the way, they can only do better from here, hopefully.
And that is the final horn. So 84-73, the Mohawk Mountaineers will be defeated on opening night here at the David Braley Athletic and Recreation Center on Mohawk College campus. They are defeated in their home and season opener. Eight new faces, as we mentioned, on the team. There will be a lot of turnover and a lot of improvement coming down the line. You expect, Coach Jonker expects a lot better from his team in the games ahead.
But Matt Elcock, we didn't see him much in the first quarter, but he finished off the game with 22 points, so still holding that 20-plus game for the Mountaineers.
And with Elcock's performance being as good as it was, we do have to unfortunately bring up some performances that were not so good. We didn't quite see the best of Lamar Barr or Kareem Collins, and those are two very, very important pieces on this team. And for Mohawk College going forward, fixing up their offensive play and their possession will be a major key piece to actually having this team be a competitive team down the line, because Niagara, as good as they look tonight, are not one of the tougher teams in the division, and they weren't one of the tougher teams last year. Now, down on the sideline, Christine Midgley is standing with the player of the game from Niagara College, Van Hutchinson Jr. Christine, take it away.
Hey guys, I'm here with number 11, Van Hutchinson of the Niagara Knights. First off, congratulations on the big win. You had a great game. You were the top scorer by far. How are you feeling right now?
I'm feeling great, you know. My team is executing. As the season go on, we're producing more better. We came out with a strategy from the tough loss to Sheridan. We didn't finish in the fourth quarter, so we made it our mission today to finish in the fourth quarter. We executed what our coach said, and it was just a great game by us. Good game by the other team. Nice competitive game. Good calling by the referees.
Yeah, well, you definitely worked to finish hard strong, and I know it's a good time right now, but we definitely saw some frustration from you throughout the game. How do you really, is it hard to pull the focus back into the game when you are having those emotions?
As a leader, and my coach is looking forward for me to keep the team together. We can't crack under pressure, whereas if one fall, I got to make sure that everybody on the same page, because if they go on a run and we're not able to execute, we're going to lose the game down the stretch, so I had to step up and be the big man and do what leaders do, finish games.
Hey, finishing is what's important. So moving forward this season, we always expect to see a lot from Niagara. What can we expect from your team moving forward?
We got a next game, tough home game against Humber. I heard that they're a tough team. They come into our house, so we got to protect the house. The season's going to be great. We executing and we're getting better as a team. Our chemistry is coming. I hope to peak at the right time of the season, and we're going to make a good run at the Nationals.
Awesome. Well, I wish you the best of luck with that. Thanks again for talking. Have a good one. Nick, Sadie, back to you guys.
Thank you, Christine. So as we come to the end of this one and everyone clears out from the David Braley Athletic and Recreation Center, me and Sadie Martin are saying goodbye and leaving you with some of the highlights from today's unfortunate loss for the Mountaineers. We'll be back with their next game, home game, scheduled up for Mohawk, and that will be men's and women's basketball. So join us again. Watch on M-Link. You can catch us here and on YouTube anytime. For Nick Burney, for Christine Midgley, and for Sadie Martin, so long and enjoy the weekend, everyone.